Breaking news: Federal government of Nigeria have arrested hip hop leader Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. I just pray this is not true, because if it's true, they are actually bringing fire upon themselves. What has this young man ever done to them? Rather than just do the right thing you're supposed to do, stop killing people, stop killing our mothers, do the right thing you're supposed to do. The federal government has arrested the leader of the proscribed indigenous people of Biafra, IPOB. The Attorney General of the Federation and Minister of Justice, Mr. Abubakar Malami San, who made the disclosure to journalists on Tuesday being today, 29th June 2021, revealed that Nnamdi Kanu was arrested and brought back to Nigeria on Sunday. He said the arrest followed a collaborative effort between security agencies in Nigeria and the Interpol. Malami further disclosed that Mazi Nnamdi Kanu could be taken before the Federal High Court in Abuja for continuation of his trial on charges bordering on terrorism, felony, unlawful possession of firearms, and management of an unlawful society. Oh my God, I don't even get it. What has this young man done to these people? Rather than protect his people, you went to their farmland, you are killing their mother, raping their young girls. Food are expensive in Nigeria today because of what the Funani we are doing, going to farmland to rape mothers, keep the ones that they can keep, and they are still cleaning up today, they are still raping up to today. Nobody is after them, nobody is after Boko Haram, nobody is after anybody. Just because this man said, organize yourself and defend yourself, why they come, as in, they are still in the Eastern Security Network, are in the East. They did not go to anybody's, so they are just in the East, inside their bush, protecting their own farmland. And you say, You, what has he done to you? I want to divorce you. Is it a crime? What have Nnamdi Kanu ever done to these people? Well, I believe God, and I know that God will not put shame. God will not put shame on his own. He always call on God, and I know God will fight for him. Yeah, God will fight for him. And I know and I believe inside me that freedom that he has been seeking for. Go to his interview when he started newly with the BBC News. BBC News were like asking him, what is it? Why can't you just let this thing go? He's asked of federal government, build good road, build good school, build good hospital. If you know the way that place that you are traveling to, the way they are, the way they are managing there, do their own. Make us know the number of citizens you have. Just do the right thing. Make this place to be safe for everybody. Federal government said no, that they will not do it. That he should just take 5 states and be eating the allowances and all those kind of things. He said no, that he can't be eating and others are hungry. Make Nigeria a better place. Look at Nigeria has become a laughing stock for everybody. If you want to do anything, just everybody is just there to watch how Nigeria has just fallen. And people say, okay, leave us, let us go. What wrong has they done? Let them go, you refuse. You are killing them. You are molesting them. You are doing this different kind of thing. People are saying, it no concern me, it no concern me. It concern everybody. I just pray this is not true, because if it is true, so thousands of people are ready to lay down their own life for this man, and it's not going to be funny at all. I just pray this is not true at all. I just pray, because if it is true, I don't know what will happen. God protect you, Nnamdi Kanu, anywhere you are, because to the little knowledge I have, I think you are fighting for the betterment of everybody, not just for your own. Not just for your own. You created ESM. Look at it, the way food are expensive in Nigeria. A painter of Gari, almost 2,000 plus. Almost 2,000 plus. Nothing is affordable. minimum wage salary of a 30,000 minimum wage, yet some people are they haven't even paid them for months, for 6 months. Even nurses, doctors, and people remaining in Nigeria, people that don't even have, as in the poor masses remaining, are the poor ones that don't even have way to even just fly, leave the country and go. You open shop, they break it, all those kind of a thing. Imagine where somebody is giving 30,000 minimum wage for a month. Nepa bill is almost 15,000 for a month. Then painter of Gari is almost 2,000. Then how will you cope? How are you coping? Thank you so much, guys.